I think you're the youngest player, Vic, in NBA history to go for 40 and 20 in a game. Even if you're not, it's just the latest in the first time. You know, Vic has done something for the first time since such and such. If you can just kind of take us through continuing to, I know that's not the goal, but just continuing to hit markers like that.
It's not the goal, but it still shows, you know, it still shows things. You know, it still shows progression. The more of those accolades I can get, the more I will get. And so it's, of course, it's also one of my, you know, convictions to be always unique and different and do things never seen before.
What's up, everybody on YouTube? AJ Russ back to discuss another video. And today, we're going to be talking about Victor Wembanyama's legendary rookie season. So guys, yes, this is the final day of the regular season that I'm recording this video. And Victor Wembanyama didn't play in his last game. The Spurs were awful this season. No one is surprised by that, having a 22-60 record. But Wembanyama, how he played this season, stepping into the expectations that he had as the number one pick, essentially being a 7'4" guard, but obviously a power forward center in actuality, his rookie season ranks up with one of the best of all time. Averaging 21 points per game on 10 rebounds and almost 4 blocks per game, literally leading the league in blocks as a rookie. That's absolutely insane. Also shooting 46% from the field and 32% from the 3-point line, which isn't the most efficient, but he can obviously knock down a 3, and he has a game like no other, like we haven't seen. That's why he's called an alien. That's why he has that Nike logo, which is an alien, which is super fire, by the way. I mean, Wemby, he's the definition of generational. There's no doubt about it. We've seen players and future Hall of Famers have sensational rookie seasons, like a Michael Jordan, who in my opinion has the GOAT rookie season. I mean, averaging 28 points per game as a rookie, literally dominated in his rookie season and then just the rest of his career. And yes, he is the GOAT in my opinion, but we're not going to talk about that conversation right now. But other players as well, like even a Blake Griffin, a Tim Duncan, Luka Doncic had a great rookie year in the 2018-19 season, LeBron James, Shaquille O'Neal as well have great rookie years. But what Wemby has done already at the age of 20 years old, it's why he's just getting started. But before I elaborate even more on this video and why Wemby is going to go down as a future Hall of Famer, the face of this league and one of the greatest that we've ever seen, make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on post notifications. Hit the like button. You know what we post about here is sports, lifestyle, pop culture, NBA, NFL videos, all types of things, cooking videos and shorts. And with all that being said, let's get into the video. So for Wemby, I talked a little bit about the numbers, but we had to discuss it. So he had over 1,500 points, over 750 rebounds, 274 assists, 250 plus blocks, and 128 three-pointers. I mean, just great numbers as a rookie. But also, he became the first player to ever score at least 1,500 points, block 250 shots, and knocked down 103 pointers. In addition to that as well, he only played 29 minutes per game. So he's not playing 40 minutes per game, 35 minutes per game doing all these stats. He's playing a reasonable amount. Of course, you have, in my opinion, the GOAT coach and Greg Popovich out there stewarding him and leading him to the right path. So that also helps. But Wemby, he's been efficient in his play. And right now, I don't want to roast the 2024 draft class, but there is no consistent number one pick like there was last year. And in most drafts, this will probably be a role player rich draft. And it looks like, depending on draft lottery, the Spurs will have around the top 5 pick. We'll see. But if they can somehow try to get a player like Rob Dillingham, I think that would be really essential for the Spurs. He has a lot to clean up in his game as well. I mean, we saw that when Kentucky lost in the first round of NCAA tournament. But adding in someone like him to help Wemby, that would help. A player like Dalton Connect from Tennessee would be pretty good for them. I don't know. I'm not the expert on this draft. I know some players, of course. But really, the Spurs, they need to get active in the free agent market and in the trade market as well. I know y'all probably heard the rumblings of potentially someone like a Trae Young maybe being an interest for San Antonio to trade for, which would be interesting, of course, because DeJounte Murray used to play in San Antonio, now a teammate of Trae Young, and this would basically, the scenario would be Trae Young going to San Antonio. But just imagine a player like that playing with Wemby. Endless lobs, the pick and roll would be disgusting. Defensively, I mean, Wemby, he'll be able to cover any guard because of his presence at the rim, just how much ground he covers, because Trae Young, let's just say, he's not the best at defense, and that's keeping it light. That would be an interesting and really good situation for Wemby. We can explore that scenario and things like that and trades of that nature. But really, for me and for the Spurs, Wembanyama, you can tell he's a competitor. They asked him about sitting out and stuff like that in the stretch of the season being over. And of course, he didn't play this last game, but he wanted to play. He wanted to represent. He said that he made a commitment to play for San Antonio, and he's been great for the team. And that's why everyone was hoping and praying that they could have got the number one pick last year. But San Antonio, they were the team to get it. And honestly, it's perfect for both sides. Victor, he's learning from one of the greatest coaches of all time in professional sports. And Pop, he has a great culture where he can be stewarded by the Tim Duncans of the world, David Robinson, his fellow Frenchman, Tony Parker, have advice from people like Manu Ginobili. I mean, his dedication is hard work, and a lot of people had injury questions because of his frame, but he's withstood that. He played 71 games. He was extremely durable. That's a scary thing for the league, because now he's going to continue to climb and climb. It wouldn't surprise me if in the 2024 or 25 season next year, if he's averaging almost 30 points, 11 to 12 rebounds, 4+ blocks, I mean, things like that, being in the MVP conversation. But in order to him to truly be in the MVP conversation, the Spurs will have to ascend as a team overall. There's no doubt that he'll be an all-star next year, in my estimation. You can make the argument that he could have been one this season, but that's that next step, not only for him, just for his career in general, is a winning part. And I didn't say it like this entirely, but the Spurs are on the clock because he wants to win, and who doesn't want to win? He's not used to losing, playing overseas, playing in Europe. They don't grow up the same as we do in America, playing AAU, going through high school, things of that nature, playing in all these tournaments. They learn the game differently. They value it more. They're more physical over there, and they take pride in the countries and the teams that they play for, and Wemby is a prime example of that, and he's adapted that Spurs culture in San Antonio, and he's going to be the next great big for them. Wouldn't surprise me if in 15 to 20 years you get a statue of Wemby outside of the Frostbank Center, but that'll ultimately be determined by the team that is set around him. But in a draft class this season that had some really good talent, and of course we'll have to judge this draft going into later years because it's still early, it's still a lot of players' rookies' years that's playing right now in the playoffs, and it's their first season adapting to the NBA. Wemby is in a class by his own, not only in terms of this draft class, but in terms of the league. If you look at players who you would pick to start your franchise with, there's only a select few players you would potentially pick over Wemby, if any. Maybe Jokic, maybe Luka. You can make the arguments of a player like a SGA, but Wemby, he's up there, and he's only 20 years old. So I know we're in playoff mode right now, getting ready to see who's going to be crowned as a 2024 NBA champion in these next 6 to 8 weeks, but make no mistake, we will eventually see Wembanyama on this stage. And in these months of playoffs and going into the offseason, we'll see what the Spurs do in the draft, in the free agent market, and maybe any potential trades. But one thing's for sure, Victor Wembanyama, he is here. He's just getting started, and his league is going to be impacted significantly because of his presence, because of his box office ability, because of his play style, his leadership, and ultimately his identity, being the specimen that he is for the San Antonio Spurs and for the NBA. But guys, y'all let me know in the comments down below what you've thought of Victor Wembanyama's rookie season. Like I said, in my estimation, it's been incredible. It sucks that it ends right now, but we'll be seeing him in the Olympics as well with Rudy Gobert, so that's gonna be crazy seeing them play together. I do expect the USA to remind everyone. Everyone's calling this the remind team because we're having players like Steph, KD, LeBron, play Jason Tatum, D-Book, Drew Holiday. It's going to be a stacked roster. Oh yeah, not to mention Joel Embiid, who also could have played for the French team. I mean, the Olympics are going to be crazy, but we're going to see more Wemby there. But like I said, guys, he is next up. I made a video like a month ago or a few weeks ago talking about why Anthony Edwards is the next face of the NBA, which he is one of the faces for sure, but I'm regretting that, not only because of that video, it did not do good at all. But it's okay. But also, when looking at Wemby, I mean, he's a prime example and model of the next face of the NBA. So let me know what y'all think in the comments down below of what you thought about Wemby's rookie year and how you see his career going further. I appreciate you guys watching. Always make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. You know what we post about here, sports, lifestyle, and pop culture. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at SwaggyRuss. Also on TikTok at SwaggyRuss02 for cooking videos, shorts, content, reels, things of that nature. More stuff is on the way, guys. Playoffs, we are almost here. It is imminent. Stay tuned for my playoff predictions video, MVP video I have coming up as well. That should be really good this week. Y'all stay tuned, guys. We're lit. I thank you for the support always. We're going to continue to elevate and keep growing. More content on the way. More stuff is on the way. Y'all be blessed. Have a good one. God loves you, and keep being great.